Oh, yes. This was a game I loved on the Amiga. And again, characterization was brilliant in it. Onga bonga and all that. It was just awesome. You could turn the music off and have sound effects. And, oh, turn my speaker down. Speaking of sound, and it goes all Maiden with like that harmony riff thing going on. Awesome. Really good soundtrack. The option on the Amiga, probably the same on this, was you could have the music or the sound, and I loved the sound every time, I have to admit, because the music got really repetitive after a while, and it kind of ended and then started again. It didn't just roll and loop, you know, which was a bit weird. But the sound effects were fantastic. They sounded like something out of the Hanna-Barbera cartoon. I don't know why I'm telling you this in the intro. Let's play the game. Just want to say, I realised that on the last game, I didn't get the option there. Oh, this is interesting. Mega Drive version's got sound and music. The sound isn't as good, of course, as the Amiga version. I'm sure this won't be as good as the Amiga version, because the Amiga could do stuff that the Mega Drive can't. And I think it had, like, you know, the copper thing going on and all that. Oh, no, I forgot, you can't jump on the reds. This is an awesome game. Look at the gorgeous graphics. Core, this was like, for me, this was Core at the best, when they were doing this sort of really beautifully detailed cartoon stuff. They did Wolf Child as well, which is one of my favourites on the Amiga. I know not everyone likes it, it's not to everyone's taste, but again, it was characterisation, and I loved it. Die, possibly insentient and arguably innocent animal creature. The last game, I didn't record the sound. Basically because I'd just done a talkie and I'm out of practice and I didn't put my sound settings back on properly. I'm hoping this one's recording the sound. I'm sure it will be. It's just, I know, I'm silly and just don't hang around there. This game, a lot of it was just figuring out. It was very sort of set PC. And if you figured out where everyone attacks you and how to dispatch them quickly, you could do a level without taking a hit, basically. I never quite got to that point, but I was pretty good at it. I've totally forgotten how to play it, but I do remember all this stuff, and it's lovely. I'm sure this version feels a little watered down in terms of detail. I'm sure the water, for example, wasn't that tiled-looking, you know, mirrored-looking. I'm sure the sky, I might be wrong, in my memory of it, had, like, a copper effect, or at least it had more washed-out colours, which you wouldn't think. Look at the mirrored stuff going on the graph. I'm sure Amiga didn't do that. You wouldn't think that washing out the colours would make the game look better, but it did, because it gave it a palette rather than this sort of garish cartooniness. And I think the Amiga version looked much better for that. That sky looks a bit too vivid and a bit too, you know, obvious. The Amiga version was prettier for being a bit more sludgy. I think, I might, you know what? If you put this, now I've said that, if you put this version against the Amiga version, you watch it, it'll be identical. But I seem to remember it not being. It's like, you know, like games like First Samurai, where the palette isn't. I wonder if I can. Yes. I'm a clever gamer. Uh-oh. Maybe not so. I see you. Yes, you get it. You can get him when he's out of his rock. I can't remember what I was just saying. Oh, First Samurai? I don't know why I was talking about that. Beautiful looking game. Very carefully thought out palettes. And I'd say arguably totally made by the artwork, but then again, the way it played was beautiful as well. But that isn't this. This is Chuck Rock, which is also brilliant, I think. I thought it was well better than any of the other. Now, this is controversial because there's people who have opinions on BC Kid and the rest of them, but I thought this was well better. Jokes. Go on, do it. Oh, he's not doing it. Oh, I thought he pooed. I'm sure on the Amiga version he pooed. Get out of me face, I'm going to go back. Poo! He poos on the Amiga. Poo! No, he's not pooing. Sorry. I don't know why I was so obsessed with seeing the poo. It was just funny when I was a kid. I'm sure he did. Maybe I dreamed it. Look at all the mirrored stuff. Was this all mirrored on the Amiga? That's mirrored. It's like they're really saving on graphics, and I don't know why. Because the Mega Drive could do this. Mega Drive's got this covered. Oh, he's annoying. He's such a small dinosaur. Oh no, he's coming back. No, come on, be brave. Yay. There we go. I'm like the proverbial elephant that's frightened of the mouse. Oh yeah, that's right. You can murder these pretty heartlessly, if I remember right. Oh, you know what? The foreground details getting on me wick a little bit. There were areas of this game that were a bit like this. Right. Ah, yeah. Look at that. I've just turned one into goo. Oh. And you know what? I really loathe on all levels cruelty to animals, but I couldn't resist stepping on the... get off me. Stepping on the tiny baby dinosaurs. Is that wrong of me? Is that the makings of a psychopath? Or is it just fun? There's a fine line, ladies and gentlemen, between fun and psychosis. I better not have... Oh, that's a long way back to come. Okay, Mikey, let's up our game a bit here. Yeah, I love this game. I mean, I got really into it. I really enjoyed it. I don't think I got particularly good at it, but I really enjoyed it when I was a kid. Oh, I say kid, teenager. I mean, I was 14 when I got my Amiga. Oh, no. That was a stupid, stupid, stupid thing to do. Back for the rocket. You stay there, little flappy feet. Man. I'm not even going to bother dispatching you. Yeah, I was 14 when I got my Amiga. 13? Something like that. So, you know, I wasn't a kid, really. I was a kid, I suppose. But I wasn't a kid like, you know, I was 9 when I got my Spectrum. I was a kid then. Why have they taken the poo out? Sorry. but I loved it. I love this game. This was like one of the many games that had me wanting to make game art, you know. Trying to reproduce or produce something similar in Deluxe Paint. Oh, Deluxe Paint. Oh, the memories. I mean, really, the memories. Man, that was such a good time. I don't know if you've ever used ProMotion. If you're partial to a bit of pixel art and you love Deluxe Paint and you've never used ProMotion, I can heartily recommend it. I used it for the first time in 2002 on a game I worked on for the Game Boy Advance, which I'm very proud of. It's my favourite game I ever worked on, I think. I used it on a lot of Game Boy Advance games, but ProMotion, it's basically Deluxe Paint for the PC, but faster and more responsive because, you know, it would be. and I can, if you like art, check out ProMotion. It's basically Deluxe Paint, but with a few more bells and whistles. And it's even got a lot of the same functionality, which is great. Get away from me with your rocks. I knew there was a bit with rocks. There was a bit before, but I knew there was another bit with rocks that was going to be a bit more tense. And that was it there. Oh, yeah. That's not right. The mechanics changed. You can bounce those rocks off your head, but not those ones. What's that about? That's not right. Wow, check him out. I love the charming little dinosaurs, though. Like cute little dinosaurs that when they get up to you, they suddenly pull out a hammer. Take you out. And I'm sure in the later levels, maybe this level on the Amiga, somewhere soon on the Amiga, there's like little cavemen. And when you hit them, the trousers fall down. Oh, no, that's right. They're in dinosaur suits. I'm not sure what the joke is. I'm sure there isn't one. I'm sure it's just the artist wanted to keep himself interested. But they were awesome. Oh, they were funny in a slightly weird, pervy way. Might have been Chuck Rock 2, which makes it pervier. But yeah, it was funny. It is Chuck Rock 2, isn't it? I'm thinking of. Oh, they kept a lot of the noises. I've just noticed through me, because I don't have the volume on very high, because, you know, speakers, microphone. And you get the audio straight from the computer, but I've just noticed that the little pterodactyl dudes actually keep the sounds from the Amiga, which was so charming and so memorable. Look at this repetition, look at this mirroring of plants. I am sure the Amiga version didn't do that. In fact, I need to go back and check on the long play, short play even, because I've got one, haven't I, for this on the Amiga. Could have played it. Music's good from what I can hear. 12-bar blues structure by the sound of it, but with like a funky 80s synthesis thing going on and rhythm. My reflexes are really not what they were. Mirroring again, look on that platform, everything's mirrored. I'm really not feeling that. If the Amiga version does that, I'll be so disappointed, because in my memory the Amiga version is so crafted, and it feels so natural, the environment. That, and this loses that quite badly. I'm sure I've gone in the wrong direction. I mean, that's my biggest disappointment, I guess. Look at that big splodge of rock there, it looks great and unique, and then look at the, and that's how the Amiga version looked all over. And then look at this with the, that log up there. It, everything's mirrored. Alright, just left to right is mirrored. Look at that, that's so mirrored. Oh, that so sucks. And the nest, everything's mirrored. I really don't like that. That's really turning me off. Which is a shame, because Chuck Rock was great. I'm so glad I didn't get into the Mega Drive version, if that's the case. The Amiga version doesn't do that, I'm sure of it. Oh, what if I'm wrong? What if it does do that? And I'm looking at it all through rose-tinted glasses. Anyway, look at the time. It's 11 minutes in. This is not right. We're supposed to be 10 minutes max. Well, doesn't really matter. Chuck Rock, Sega Mega Drive. Bit disappointed with the mirroring that's going on. It's making my eyes hurt, which is a shame. Music's fine. Sound effects seem to be okay-ish. Most of them are there. It's cool. The backgrounds just feel really, what's the word? Can't remember the word. Kind of quantized though, and it was never like that. Why are they cutting it down so much in the Mega Drive, graphics wise? Didn't need to, look at Earthwind Jim, etc. Thanks for watching.